This episode is brought to you by Target. You've spent weeks arguing about The Mandalorian. You'll spend months arguing about The Rise of Skywalker. Now, watch the one Star Wars movie capable of uniting the entire fan base by agreeing it's the worst theatrically released movie in the franchise. Easily. Star Wars, The Clone Wars, the movie. The show is a different story. Gear up for a movie based on a vague reference to something Mark Hamill said in 1977.
You fought in the Clone Wars?
Yes.
But since the Samurai Jack guy made them look kick-ass one time, Lucasfilm followed up with a poorly animated kids movie. Really poorly animated.
I'd best be on my way.
Like, so poorly animated, every scene ends with the same animation of someone crossing their arms. Did they forget to render this? Looks like an educational Star Wars spin-off game designed to teach me how to type. Your favorite prequel characters are back. Yay! Like Anakin Skywalker, who's only killed sand people at this point. Not younglings. So he's good. Obi-Wan, who took all the stiffness out of his personality and transferred it to his hair. Christopher Lee and Sam Jackson, who didn't get the memo they could skip this one.
I need three of his Star Cruisers.
A bunch of nameless clones.
Thanks for the ride, Rex.
Cody, battle positions.
Aw, don't name your clones, man. You're just gonna get attached. Ahsoka Tano, a sidekick built out of corporate memos to make a cool young girl Jedi who's cool and does cool stuff.
You're stuck with me, Sky Guy.
What did you just call me?
And Baby Yoda, his exact opposite, Stinky. Oh, Stinky, you're a mistake no one will ever speak of again. Begun the Clone Wars have. And boring the Clone Wars are, because this is 90 solid minutes of droids shooting at clones, clones shooting at droids, and space wizards flipping around in the middle of it all, helping the clones shoot the droids more better. But since we know the same guy is running both armies, we know this is all a big distraction that means absolutely nothing. Unless you're the guy who owns the rights to the blaster sound effect. In that case, cha-ching, am I right? So strap in for the first Star Wars set entirely inside an actual Star War that's somehow more boring than the holiday special. At least that had Wookiees watching VR porn. Still, it does feature the greatest redemption story in Star Wars. No, not that guy. Dave Filoni, who somehow shook off this mess and turned it into multiple compelling seasons of television, turned this brat into one of the most popular characters in the fandom, and proved that there's room for more than one Hollywood nerd in a cowboy hat. El Mariachi versus the Mandalorian, guys. At least give it some thought. Starring Darth Vader, Poochie. A good movie? Now that's a thing I haven't made in a long time. Padme Amidadeyes, Mr. and Mrs. Sith, BattleBots, and Baby Slug Doop 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 Baby Slug Doop 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 Baby Slug Doop 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 Baby Slug. PS2 Jedi Power Battles. So, this is around 20 years before A New Hope, and jizz music hasn't changed at all? Are these guys playing brand new cutting-edge jizz? Or does the Mos Eisley Cantina have a retro jizz theme? This holiday, the toys of a generation of Star Wars fans come home. Explore a whole galaxy of Star Wars toys, available at Target. Marvel, DC. No one on the internet has ever thought of making a video comparing the relative strengths of their heroes until now. Click here for an all-new episode of Power Levels, and see if you can handle Superman's pelvic thrust.